correct office for the fake.
I'm sorry, Pixie. She said anyone but you.
Why?
Well, we won't go into that. Keen, you could be our volunteer.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, all right, Pixie. You can come too, but only on tray duty. We can't have Mrs. O'Regan walking out on us. It'd
be a bit hard making doppies on a tray.
You'll manage.
Now, you're looking very happy. What's the good news?
I am going to the factory.
Oh, that's wonderful. I didn't think Mrs. Reynolds would stop you from seeing your family.
Yeah. I did lose a month's buy-up, but geez, you should have heard the report Miss Ferguson put in.
Well, I wouldn't worry about that too much. We could help you with buy-up.
Well, you can have mine. I won't be needing it.
Oh, no. I've got to front the freak with a name after dinner.
Don't worry, Bobby. We won't let her take it out on you.
Well, madam, it'll be just like any other fete. There'll be jams, bric-a-brac, lucky dips.
Oh, yes, yes, you'll be perfectly safe. There'll be lots of security.
Yes, lots and lots of officers. Good. Well, we'll see you tomorrow then. Goodbye. I'm surprised she didn't ask for an armed bodyguard.
Hello, Joyce.
Hello, Pam. Long time no see. Mr. Manning's friend, aren't you?
Is he here? Can I see him?
No, I'm sorry, dear. He's tied up at the moment. On the white line, please. Good. Now, your name is Rachel Louise Milson. Is that correct? My dear, you must answer the question. Is that your name?
Rick.
Oh. Mr. Manning, would you like to do the induction?
No. I just a few formalities. It won't take long. Just hang in there, all right?
Why aren't you in the dining room, Mitchell?
I'm not hungry. I tried to find out who called Camilla, but I couldn't find out.
Don't give me that, you know. You all know.
And ask us.
Well, I don't have to. You three goons have just told me all I want to know.
Yeah? What's that?
Well, you see, I checked all the phone calls for that night. And the only one on the list you'd want to protect is Mason. Yeah. Thought so.
You leave Bobby alone.
Me? Oh, Parker, I've got what I want. Without any heavy stuff. So unless you're planning to start some, I suggest you get out of my way. You're losers. You're all losers.
Ferguson.
If anything, anything at all happens to Pixie or Bobby, you're going to be the loser. Oh, it won't be me or Judy or Cass. You'll be up against every woman in this prison with any semblance of guts. And we'll tear you apart.
Nothing but the best, eh?
You can't be referring to the accommodation.
How are you getting on with the other women?
They detest me.
That's not surprising.
Oh, really? I was surprised. In fact, I was astounded to find two of my dresses cut to ribbons.
When?
This afternoon.
Did you report it?
Oh, what's the point?
Malicious damage should be reported to an officer.
Don't forget it. They were last season's anyway.
Rather now.
I made rather a grand gesture and deposited them with the inmates.
Do you have any idea who did it?
The one called Red didn't seem particularly surprised when she saw them.
Want to lay a formal complaint against Keane?
Oh, it's not worth it, really. It could have been any one of them. They all seem capable of a lot worse than that.
They are. But then if you're not willing to make a complaint, I can't do anything about it.
Good. Then the matter's finished. Good night, Miss Ferguson.
Going
to
thaw out
any minute now. What the? What is this stuff?
Oh,
no, someone put oil in my shampoo bottle. Jesus! Oh, honey!
Well, look at it this way, kid. You're saving a lot on conditioner. Oh, wow.
Morning, Rick.
Hi, Governor.
So you did stay all night. I was hoping you wouldn't.
She finally got to sleep. I don't know what to do.
It's your last day. It'll be easier when you get away from here.
What?
Well, you'll be able to visit her without the restrictions an officer's uniform puts on you.
Well, that won't do her much good.
Of course it will. You know how important visits are to the women in here?
Well, she is not like the women in here. Oh, God, what am I saying? I really didn't mean that the way it sounded. It's her upbringing. She's not equipped for this place. Can you help?
I'll do what I can to help her settle in, but I can't single her out for special attention, Rick. Of course, how she copes with the other women's very much up to herself.
Yeah, you're right.
Rick, I'm arranging farewell drinks for after work. Is 5:30 all right for you?
Oh, Governor, thanks anyway, but I'm not really in a party mood. Give it a miss if you don't mind.
I know you're taking the mickey, but...
Oh, never.
If you don't give over, we're going to be here all day.
Good.
Yeah. Now, where's Lee Templar?
Yeah.
You're not down for work.
That's not Lee Templar, it's olive oil.
Sunflower oil. All right, now give a man a go.
Oh, any time, bud.
Careful, they're after your Yorkshire pudding.
I don't know about you, lots of them. I'm used to handling boys. I mean, I'm used to dealing with lads.
Yeah, we know.
Now, let's keep it fragrant and get on with it, shall we? Now, the following ladies, Desmond, Bryant, Mitchell, Keane, Mason, Parker and Hunt, are in the laundry. Is that understood?
Never heard of them.
I'll give up.